Good morning, student. Today we shall be going up with the second part of Rain on the Roof by poet Coates Kinney. In this poem, we had begun. The poet describes or visualizes the raindrops are like the tear that sheds from the shining starry sky. And he also experiences, he is also nostalgic about his innumerable association that is connected with the imagination connected with the rain. And he remembers his mother whose benevolent looks appear before him. He experiences a great satisfaction in her looks as he enjoys listening to the patter of the rain on the roof. So let us begin. First stanza we have already completed in our last session. Now today we are moving up with our second stanza. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart, and thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start, and thousands recollections weave their ear threads into woof. Now children, see here, every tinkle is a sound of the rain that falls on the shingle. Shingles, what is shingle? It is a small smooth stone for the tiles used for the construction of the house roof, and it falls on that, and he enjoys the sound of the this echoing sound of this shingle has an echo in the, and it echoes in the depthness of his heart, and thousand dreamy fancies, and he becomes nostalgic. He moves to his past and thinks about, remembers all those fancies that he has enjoyed. Into busy being start, and he says it is the memories that he remembers, imagine things he remembers, and with this and thousand recollections, and remember thousands of things that are there in past, weave their threads into woof, and he remembers those things, and he also says that weaves their thread, the way the cloth is woven, the same way he says those things, they are interlinked with each other. This is the explanation, that is for stanza 2. Now let us move up with the word meanings. And word tinkle here is the sound of rain falling on the stone. Echo is resounding sound. Okay, and then the collections of recollection is the memories. Shingles are the small smooth stones which are of red color, you might have seen, in order to build the roofs. Fancies is imagining things. Okay, now next we move to the literally device. Rhyme scheme is the same as we have done for the first answer. It is A, B and C, D, and then E, E, F, E. Okay, this is the same rhyming scheme we have. And then we talk about onomatopoeia is there. Tinkle is a sound that describes of, that's a description about the rain. Then we have personification. Woof, thousand recollections, thousands of collections. It is personification because woof, weaving is done by the human. It is a quality of a human which has been compared with that of the things, that of a rain, and here it is personified. Now again, transferred epithel is their dreamy fancies. Okay, we have an adjective with the noun, and it is not personifying the fancies, but it is personifying a quality of a, that is to a human. It is the human's eyes, the human being who dreams about. Now see the question based on this extract. Why does the poet hurt echo? The poet hurt echo because the tinkling sound of a raindrops on the roof. What do the old memories do? The old memories create a fanciful pictures. And what do the raindrop stirs in the poet? It stirs the old memory of the poet's heart. And whose look does the poet think of on hearing the raindrops? The poet think of fearing the looks of his benevolent mother. Okay, he remembers the mother. Now class, let us begin with the third stanza. Now in memory comes my mother. Now he says in his memory his mother come, and she used in the years gone, and the way she do, that is nostalgic. A gone is those days which are already gone, to regard the darling dreamers and to love their darling dreamers, that is his brother and sisters all, ere she left them it till dawn. It is the time is now, she has left them for the down. Ere means before. Oh, I feel her fond look on me. And she says, he says, I could feel her looking on me. As I listen to this refrain, as he says, as he hears the sound of the rain, the sound of the song, which is played upon the shingles, which dances on the shingles, on the roof of the tiles of the, tiles on the roof of the house, by the patter of the rain, and says by the patter, by the sound of the rain. Now so this is the explanation. Now see, the there are very few words. Agone is there, which is mean past. Air means before. Dawn is early morning, and darling, you know that it means beloved. Let us move up with the literally devised. Rhyme scheme is same as for the other, that is ABCD E, F, E. Alliteration is there, for example, memory, mother, M, sound. Then darling dreamer is there, D, sound. We have onomatopoeia there, which is which describes the sound of the rain. It is patter over there. Okay, now let us move up with the questions. Who comes in the memory of a child when it rains? It is his. Who is it? It is mother who comes in his rain. And what does the poet like to do when it? He like to press the pillow and lie listening the pattering of the rain, the sound of the rain, the dancing of the rain sound. The what are the darling dreamers in the poem? Who are the darling dreamers? They are his poet's brother and sister. The poet listen to the what does poet listen? He listen to the sound of the rain. And that's all in this poem. Class, kindly go through the poem, enjoy the sound of the rain, the rainy season, and admire it the way the poet admire and pen it down in a beautiful lines. Thank you students, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the class.